What's up guys, welcome back to another video. Today I am super excited to share a fight scene with you from one of my favorite TV series ever. It is called The Witcher, it's currently available on Netflix. This video will contain some spoilers for the show because I will be breaking down a fight scene from a later episode. So if you don't want to get any spoilers, make sure you go watch the show first, but if you guys have already seen the show or you don't really care about the spoilers, I'm going to jump in here, break down The Witcher versus the Striga fight, and as I do this, I'm going to share some of my thoughts as a professional stuntman on how they created some of the action, and also I will point out to you exactly how and why Henry Cavill actually does all his own stunts. Hey guys, it's Ruustic from the future. As I'm editing this video, I just wanted to clarify something really quick. Even though Henry does do all of his own stunts in this fight scene, there is still a stunt coordinator, stunt team, and stunt double there setting up the shots and testing them out before Henry would have done them. But that still doesn't take anything away from how impressive it is for this actor to perform stunts in this level of difficulty on his own. There's actually, honestly, a lot of stuff in here that is like almost flawless. So some of the stuff in here, even I can't tell how they're doing, but we're gonna do this together and we're gonna check it out. So anyways, let's just jump right in. So before I continue, just let me introduce myself. My name is Ruustic Bodomov. I'm a professional stuntman, and on this channel, I make videos where I teach people how to do stunts. I break down action movies, and I also do my own action comedy videos. So if you guys are new to my channel, welcome. Hopefully you enjoy your stay. If you like what you see, please subscribe. Also, a quick shout out to the end screen gang from the last video. You guys are awesome. Anyways, let's just jump in here. All right, so really quick backstory on what we're about to see here. This guy right here, his name is Geralt. He is the Witcher. He's a supernatural human and he goes around and hunts monsters. And so in this episode, he is fighting a monster called a Striga, which is a girl who used to be a girl, but she was born out of her mom who died because it was like cursed. And it's really, really complicated. Geralt here is fighting this monster at nighttime inside of this abandoned castle. His goal is to make it to sunrise so the monster will turn it back into a girl. So he has to beat this monster, not die himself, but also not kill the monster to be able to save it so then she can turn back into a girl. So that is the backstory here. Obviously, this is a human fighting a monster, so there's going to be a lot of like supernatural type stuff. In the actual game, which I just started playing, The Witcher 3, you're able to use a little hand signs, so he has a little bit of magic powers, and he also has a silver sword, which he uses to fight monsters, but he actually doesn't take the sword out in this fight scene. Anyways, here we go. We have a castle, and we have the monster coming in. That is the Striga. Boom, walking in slow motion. Creepy hand, creepy umbilical cord. That's gross, by the way. I just want to say to the filmmakers, like, that is a gross detail, but obviously it makes you feel that the monster is creepy. Then you see it for the first time, and it is doing that. Boom. Look at that face. Can you believe that used to be a girl? I can't either. Alright, here comes Geralt. Boom, that thing looks serious. Alright, Geralt starts swinging the spinny. Monster does his little thing, like... why? Boom. Throws it on. Catches it. Boom. Rips it open. Boom. So this right here is probably an actual costume, which looks really dope. So the performer's arms probably came to here, and he's probably holding on to these ends. Boom. I just personally don't like that head movement. Oh snap, the chain has snapped, and here comes the fight. We have the Striga come up and jump on Geralt. So this right here would be a wire stunt. The guy in a costume gets lifted by a wire off the screen. Boom, flying forward, another shot of it from the back. And for this shot right here, it would have just started off screen and jumped with Geralt onto a pad. Boom, there would have been a pad off the screen down here. Whoosh, just jumping past the frame. They both start sitting up a little bit off the screen. Boom, probably squatting down. Then they fall into frame. Then you have this little bit right here. This guy in the suit just basically jumps like a foot. At the same time that Henry Cavill pushes him, boom, hits the wall. Also, I just want to mention really quick, I'm pretty sure that Henry Cavill did most of his own stunts on this one. And usually actors just like to say that they do all their own stunts. But in this case, I think he actually did. So hats off to Henry. Also, I think he did a really good job as the Witcher. Okay, so this part right here, as the Striga comes up and gets lifted down, so this would have been a guy in a suit just starting here and jumping. He probably would have had the help of a wire just a little bit to lift him up for him to be able to stick to the wall for a second and then drop to the ground. Boom. Going forwards. Got a couple dodges. Now this shot right here I thought was really cool. Here we have the Witcher using a little bit of his magic power. This Striga gets taken off his feet, hits the wall back there, boom, and turns around. This is the first shot that I was really wondering how they did it. I'm pretty sure that the way they start this is a practical effect, which means there's a guy in costume right here. There's a wire. He's going back 25, 30 feet on a wire gag called a ratchet, which means that he's connected to a wire going backwards. I did one of these before, it was scary, but the wire is connected to a cylinder with compressed air in it and a series of pulleys. So then when somebody presses the button, the cylinder makes the pulleys yank the wire all the way. So that's why it would happen so quickly. So I'm pretty sure that's what they did here. The first part would be a ratchet. So the guy goes all the way back there, boom. But if you watch how the monster falls to the ground, how quickly it falls, I'm pretty sure that's VFX. There's no mat down there, and that's a gnarly impact. So what I think they did here is a combination of practical stunt and VFX, which I think always looks the best. I've combined practical stunts with VFX on some of my own projects before, and it always turns out looking more realistic. Boom, practical, VFX. Then you have Geralt coming up. Notice how he's not taking out his sword, because he has a silver sword which kills monsters, but he's actually trying to save this girl. He dodges it, grabs the torch off the wall, and now he's going to use that. Boom, hits it. So all the action right there is practical. They're just using what we call stacking. So Geralt here, when he swings it, there's just enough distance between them. The camera's actually further back than you think it is. It's zoomed in, so it squishes the distance between them. So he swings at the face. Stacks the hit, boom, they stack this. And I actually like how, if you notice, when he hits this wall, he starts moving down. Next frame, he's already like on the ground, just sitting into it. Boom, he hits the wall and he bounces off, moving in this direction. And that's the same direction that he's moving on the next cut, which makes it super smooth. Boom. This shot, I think, is like really gross. Look at it. Boom, goes up. Goes across. This shot right here is really cool, I think, the way it was designed. So you have the Witcher laying on the ground. He gets lifted with the help of a wire up to this wall. So this guy in this suit is holding him up. Then he goes from this wall to this wall. Boom. He's being held up by a wire a little bit. And also you can tell it's Henry because right here you can see his face. One side note I want to say too is the sword on his back here while they're doing all the stunts. It's actually a rubber sword because it would be really dangerous to have the main actor with a real looking sword that can jab into the back of his head. And also you can see it bend just a little bit right here as it goes into this wall and he hits it, boom. But really well done. Simple fall right here. All this guy holding him up had to do is just lower him to the ground. So boom, gets lowered to the ground. And we come to the first big wire gag, which I think Henry did himself. Because if you look at this, you see his face clearly, and it's the same shot which pans over and has this wire gag. And I was actually trying to find where the cut point was, because normally the way you would do this is you would have the main actor here, you know, take his reaction, and this pan right here would normally hide a cut. That way this would be a stunt double doing that fall, because you can't really see his face. He lands, boom. And I can't find the cut. To me, it looks like Henry did this himself. So he lands here, you can see his face. But usually it's the hair and the clothes that you see the hidden cuts in. But like if you pay attention to the hair, like the hair really doesn't jump or change much. Like I don't know where the hidden cut would be. So pretty sure that's Henry Cavill doing his own stunts. He's out. Striga comes in, lands on top of him. Once again, I think this is a combination of VFX and a real gag. The real guy was probably here the whole time and he just gets lowered onto him on a wire. So it goes VFX, we have a real guy come in, lowered onto him. This part's really cool. He uses his magic. Doosh. This would have been a really cool rig that they made where they had trapdoors open and the ground break off. maybe some mass to land on underneath. Boom, goes through, lands. Looking around. Oh, the Striga is asleep. Boom, made a barrier. I really like this world. I actually ended up watching the show with subtitles on because there's so much details to it. Oh snap. Oh! Cool wire stunt right there. Once again, you see Henry's face right here. And the way they would have done this wire stunt in particular is you have Henry here, he is ready for the stunt. And as soon as he gets pulled on a wire, see how he hits sideways? That means that he would have had a wire coming from under his armpit over here and one coming from his hip and also another wire pulling him back this way. That way, when he flew back, he turned sideways in the air. He hit the wall. He also probably had another wire on his front stopping him from flying into the wall full force. Boom. And then once he hit, they dropped him to the ground. This throw right here is pretty simple. So you can see here, he starts on his feet and kind of just like launches himself forwards. Okay, that one. Let's watch it again. You see Henry Cavill's face, boom, in a nice close-up. And then he goes up on a wire, hits the pole, spins around it, and goes all the way to the ground, right? Okay, normally this would be a close-up for the actor, and then somewhere in here would be a cut. So a stunt double could just do this, boom, go around, and hit the ground. And that way you wouldn't see the stunt double's face, right? But watch once again, like pay attention to the hair as it goes around. Like the hair stays the same. All right guys, so now that I've proven to you that Henry does do his own stunts in this fight scene, let me just explain exactly how they set up this wire rig. So as you see, when Henry gets picked up by this monster, he has to turn 3/4 of the way by the time he hits the pole. Then he bounces off of it with some nice dust effect here and comes around to this side. So what I think they did here is called a half wrap, which means that he had a wire coming down from the ceiling and it was coming around underneath his body and hooked to his right hip. That way, when the wire started lifting him, his body got spun naturally. He's probably connected right here. And that's why the momentum stopped right there. And he was able to spin around and get lowered by the wire to his left hip. Boom. So he still had a wire there. Now, he may or may not have had the help of another wire on this hip right here just to help swing his legs around. But honestly, by how badass this actor really is and like by the other stunts I've already watched, I'm pretty sure he did this with just the one wire and actually took this impact, boom. Maybe it was a padded column, maybe it wasn't, but then he would have spun around and lowered down. Badass. What's he gonna do? Brass knuckles. He's gonna punch the shit out of this monster with some silver knuckles. It's coming back. Hey, whoosh. I think this whole shot is probably VFX. Because he just hits the ground so brutally, like, I don't know if a real stunt person would do that. Also, when you see a human hit the ground from a wire gag, they will kind of like tap their foot down or kind of tap their hand down just a little bit to help them take the impact. But if you look at this creature, it just goes directly to its back and everything slaps down on the ground. So it's just like, I mean, it's more realistic, like what would actually happen if somebody got thrown. But when you throw humans, they tend to put their limbs out to help themselves. Like if we go back to this one right here, watch how he kind of taps down his toe and his hand, boop, and then takes the fall. It also looks more natural too. It looks more like, oh snap, I'm falling, great. But for this creature one, I think it was all the effects because look how it falls. Is he gonna make it? The sun's coming up. What Geralt has to do is keep it out of its coffin, because it has a coffin that it sleeps in. He runs, they run, they ooh. That was a cool shot too. Pretty sure Henry Cavill was on a wire and this would have been a VFX monster. So they just added the impact in VFX. Boom. Crawls in there. And now it can't do anything. Seals it up. Man, that's an ugly monster. And that is the fight scene. So if you want to know what happens next, go actually watch the show. I honestly just wanted to share this with you because I absolutely love the show. I bought the video game, I'm playing it right now. Geralt, the Witcher character, is actually, I think, currently like my top favorite character out of anything that I've read or played or whatever. So absolutely in love with the show. It's on Netflix. Also really helped me to watch it with subtitles on because there's a lot of details you could miss. Anyways, guys, hopefully you enjoyed this breakdown. Let me know down in the comments if there's anything else you'd like me to have a look at. I do have a whole playlist of these breakdowns about different types of TV shows and movies. So if you want to check that out, there's going to be a link down below. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate you, and I'll see you on the next video. Peace.